Over 1.8 billion years ago, a massive event occurred in our solar system. An asteroid about 10 to 15 kilometers, or 6 to 9 miles across, ended its journey through space in a dramatic collision with Earth. This impact created what we now know as the Sudbury Basin in Ontario, Canada, turning it into a geological marvel. This ancient event laid the groundwork for one of the world's most affluent mineral areas. Today we're going to explore this fascinating chapter of Earth's history, from the catastrophic impact to its influence on the land's geology, and how the remnants of this ancient asteroid continue to shape our world and society. The asteroid's approach would have been a spectacle in the sky, visible for days or weeks before the impact. The asteroid's entry into the Earth's atmosphere would have created a brilliant fireball, lighting the sky with an intense glow. Life existed in its most basic forms. But if observers on the ground did exist back then, they might have seen a bright streak across the sky as the asteroid hurtled towards its collision point. As previously mentioned, the asteroid, which was around 10 to 15 kilometers or 6 to 9 miles in diameter, collided with Earth during the Paleo-Proterozoic era, some 1.8 billion years ago. The impact site, now known as the Sudbury Basin, was transformed into a fiery cauldron, a temporary lava lake with temperatures high enough to melt rock. The original crater was estimated to be around 250 kilometers or 155 miles in diameter, a vast wound on the Earth's surface. Today, the basin measures approximately 60 by 30 kilometers or 37 by 18.6 miles. The impact created multiple rings, a feature often found in large impact craters on moons and planets throughout our solar system. I made a video on some of the largest impact craters that exist in our solar system, and many of them had this multiple ring feature. The force of the collision would have been felt far and wide. In fact, it would have been felt planet-wide, with shockwaves radiating outwards, destroying everything in their wake. And the earthquake that was produced would have been one of the largest that have ever occurred in our planet's history. The moment of impact would have been cataclysmic. The ground would have shaken violently, and a massive explosion would have sent debris flying for hundreds of kilometers. The heat and pressure would have been so intense that rocks melted, and the landscape was, obviously, forever altered. A shockwave would have spread out from the impact site, creating tsunamis in any nearby bodies of water. The sky would have been filled with dust and debris, blocking the sun and creating a temporary quote-unquote impact winter. One of the most harrowing consequences of an enormous asteroid impact is the phenomenon that occurs as ejected debris re-enters the Earth's atmosphere. This debris, travelling at incredible speeds, superheats the atmosphere within minutes or even seconds. The temperatures can soar to levels higher than the surface of the sun, reaching several thousand degrees Celsius. This isn't a slow or localised event, it's an instantaneous global catastrophe. The entire planet becomes engulfed in a searing heatwave. This intense heat would literally sterilise everything. After the impact, a central uplift dome remained. This occurred when the Earth's crust, compressed by the force of the impact, bounces back, creating a dome-like structure in the crater's center. This dome is a characteristic feature of large impact events and is still visible in the Sudbury Basin. The surrounding area would have experienced significant geological changes, including faulting, folding, and the creation of new metamorphic rock formations. The landscape would have been scarred and reshaped, with pristine mountains, valleys, and lakes forming due to the immense forces unleashed. Now, an interesting process unfolded as the Earth began to recover from this event. The intense heat from the impact melted a large part of the Earth's crust, creating a pool of molten rock and metal. As it cooled, heavier elements like nickel, platinum, gold, and copper sank, while lighter minerals floated to the top. This process, known as magmatic differentiation, led to the formation of concentrated metal deposits that exist in layers, which is a dream for someone like me, who loves this kind of stuff. Over time, these deposits became part of the Sudbury Igneous Complex, now the world's largest source of magmatic nickel. More than $1 billion worth of metal ores are extracted each year from this region. The complex comprises several types of rocks, including norite, quartz gabbro, and granophyre. Now, we've already made a video on the largest impact site on Earth, which is located in South Africa, link to that in the description below, and this underwent a similar mineralization process, and as a result of this massive asteroid impact, which occurred only 200 million years before this one, led to the formation of the world's largest gold deposits. The story of the Sudbury Basin is a vivid reminder of these types of catastrophic events. And even though it occurred billions of years ago, it still continues to shape our world and society in significant ways. From the chaos of an ancient asteroid impact, valuable resources were formed. Resources that have fueled human progress for centuries. Thank you for joining us on this exploration of one of Earth's most intriguing geological events. The Sudbury Basin's story is a testament to the interconnectedness of our universe and the enduring influence of space events on our daily lives. Thanks for watching.